Welcome to Ride With Me, the Bukumi Preacher Show. Have you ever wondered what happened in the life of your favorite celebrity? What they do when they drive around the city? Do they sing when they drive? Do they shout at other road users? Guys, that and many more will be answered on this show. And I get to ask them private questions so you know them more intimately. Promise kept, right? So guys, buckle up. Come ride with me. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to pick up Jafet and Mozua. Okay. Mr. Gigi.
Good morning, how are you doing?
I'm very well, sir. Good morning, how are you today?
Fine, thank you.
I did promise to drop you off at the airport. What happened? That too?
No, that's fine.
Okay, you're making me feel like you're big.
I'm not big. I just needed more space.
You know, the first time I saw you, I was shocked. So this is something big.
Most people that meet me for the first time, they expect to see an older guy and a very big one for them.
I'm telling you, the first time I was able to take pictures with you and I posted it, my mom said, Baba, Twitter, you're going. I said yes. I said, sure, honey. I said yes.
We're cool.
You did something that is annoying me on this show about your book.
I mean, I'd apologize for that, but what's it?
Good, let me explain. This is your book. See?
Yeah.
This is not your book.
Yeah, this is it.
It's not related. It's the one that you signed for me.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, come on, where is the signature? That you signed. It's that book coming. More grace and greatness for Mojua.
Yeah.
I don't even know the way you spell your name.
It's
that you signed this one. Yeah. Now, acknowledgement. The people that are making wave in Nigeria, social media, your friends, you put them. Yeah. You did not put my name.
Let me explain. It's very easy. One is easy.
Yeah.
It's people that I've had repeated interactions with.
All
these years.
All these years.
So now both of us are building, we are building a friendship. So my next book, if I decide to have a word cloud, you'd automatically be.
I forgive you for this book.
Thank you for not putting
my name. I can expect that the next one, my name
will be a word cloud.
If you do a word cloud. Yeah, if you do a word cloud. But this is first. I've not seen this before.
Yeah, it's the first time.
Okay.
I don't know if I want to do it again, but it's the first time.
I know that you are a very fearless someone. You speak your mind. But if there's something that I've tried to learn from you, it's the fact that you are very objective.
I try to be. We all have our biases.
I've seen a few tweets where people want to kill you on Twitter for saying this, for saying that, and saying you're not God, you make your own mistakes. Mm. But there was a particular year like that you criticized the big name in Lagos, perhaps the Lord of Lagos, like they call him.
Okay.
But you did something. You did something. You did something, and I know that you respect these people. At least you don't disrespect them.
I don't criticize people out of.
But you spoke to authority. You know they fear Lagos. You know they fear.
No, the thing is, you know these people. They are not idiots. Some of their fans and followers are. They can't help themselves. Those are idiots. Of course, they also have smart fans.
You hate mediocrity. Like you are angry with ignorance every time. you are supposed to be able to read.
Person in a powerful position, no matter what you say, more often than not, the person that attains a powerful position is not a fool.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah, because
they know the difference between somebody that is criticizing them because this person just hates me. They know it from somebody that somebody paid to go and criticize them. Somebody that if they do a good thing, this person will say it. If they do a bad thing, this person will say it. And they also understand that even though they are our elders, they are our babas in the society, they also understand the place of the individual to say things about the country and the state and whatever, because if you're in a position of power, that's what comes to your position. So there's nothing to be afraid of. These are people that are rational. They are people in power, except for some isolated ones that got there by mistake and they are just also themselves foolish.
Yes, you can see.
I don't think any person in such position will feel like because somebody is asking better
of
their leadership.
In trouble because of your tweets, like you.
Yeah, of course, but I try not to make a big deal of those things because for me the idea is not for you to have a voice. The idea is for you to have a voice to the point where people are not afraid of having their own voices.
Okay.
And so what you try to do is to avoid making the difficulty of that thing the reality. You try to de-emphasize the dangers and the risks involved in being that person. But definitely, yes.
There's something that happened in the Nigerian space recently about religion.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if I can call you a church boy, but I know that you love the Lord.
Yeah,
you're a Christian.
I'm a Christian to the core.
But few pastors came out to say their own part of the tight thing, you know, what God has to say about it.
Yeah.
But even before then,
yeah,
you came out and you were clear about what you think the church should do about that.
Yeah.
I don't know, because sometimes I felt that some of these things are, you know, religious. There's nothing that you cannot touch.
For me, my biggest power is my freedom.
Okay.
And any friendship or mentorship that tries to take that away from me will end.
Oh. Yes,
if I cannot express my freedom, that's a problem. That's why I appreciate my pastor. I don't have any fear that my pastor will come and say, my pastor will come and say, that thing that you posted, you know, I cannot.
He follows you.
It doesn't just follow me and you and his members. He actually sees everything.
There was a day in retweeted one of my jokes, and I was like, so I think
you should be more concerned about the ones he does not retweet, because he sees everything. But the beauty of his leadership is that he won't try to try and get in the way of your voice. He knows that he has a responsibility as a pastor and as a leader.
To tell you
he knows
what
that you have a responsibility as a comedian, you as an actress, you as an activist, you as an active citizen.
And a million and one of us are running.
And he respects all that. If you attend any place of worship where you are afraid of saying the things on your mind because your pastor or your imam is going to come after you, then you're not in the right place.
Okay,
you're being restricted from growing, expressing your humanity. I will never hide myself from anyone. You have to choose whether to stay or to
leave.
But I will never hide. If I was a smoker, I'd smoke publicly.
Okay.
Right? Anything that I do that is not against the law, I will do it publicly, because I can't live my life by hiding.
By hiding,
I didn't come to this planet to hide from anyone. I came to express myself to the fullest per day, per time. So when they abuse you, really, nobody knows. So it doesn't look like you've been abused, because you've not replied. So it's when I reply that it looks like, why am I answering these people? But the truth of the matter is, for every person I reply, there are 200 people that I ignored.
How do you manage? Chen with PDP, Jacks was around, everybody's around, and you're friends with everybody.
I relate to human
beings. But you're not a card-carrying member.
I was a card-carrying member of one political party,
okay,
I will still have an open-door policy to everyone.
Mm.
Because look, we cannot define ourselves by our political leanings.
Okay.
We are first of all human beings. Right, and there are good people and bad people in every party, in every religion, in every country, in every race, in every profession.
Oh,
it should be about the people, the individual. Like, I'm a believer in the individual as much as I believe in the collective.
The collective.
So I will treat you as an individual. That's why if you bring bad energy, I will give it back to you double dose, if not multiple that. Right,
that's an individual.
But to say because somebody is a member of some party, even if I was a member of a political party, I would still be able to bring people together.
From
different parties.
Oh, that's admirable. Okay.
So it's important to be able to do that.
Let me ask you this final question before I allow you go.
Okay.
But I would need to pop, but I need to show you something from your book.
Okay.
I've been going through the book, looking for stories, you know, trying to pick stuff. I want to share, follow you to grow to see. I don't know how do you feel that much power? See how much followers you have. You can just say anything and people follow you. They just believe that, maybe I said it. So
it's
I saw a particular story.
Yeah.
Let me pack so that I can show you.
Yeah.
A guy, just like one of them, okay, that you say you ignored. There's a particular guy that you've tried to ignore him. This guy came to church. You're trying to help someone now. They're trying to help someone. And took your pictures.
I didn't even know, you know.
You didn't know. You took your pictures. Or just see yourself on social media. Mm.
saying things. This is where I'm going. You make sure that they pick the guy on a Friday. Because you are sure that in Nigeria, when you are,
it was Thursday, he wanted Friday,
so that he could stay. Friday. Then they know they did the job, they did it better. I say you are powerful. They make sure that they pick the guy on Thursday.
The Friday was a public
holiday. Was a public holiday, so Baba was there till. Are you mean?
I can be mean. I can be mean. I'm a very, I think I'm a very nice person. I think I'm a very, very kind person. I think I do my best to help people. But when somebody asks for my mean side, you can get it.
A good
my
dose.
Mean side is not dead.
Okay.
I don't use it, but it's not dead.
But you don't try and
it's good to not call on that side. It's good to not call on that side. I try to do what Jesus asks for when he gets slapped on the right, he turned the left. I try to do that.
Really,
but
a lot of people.
You know, I mean, it's okay sometimes. It's okay, you know. Just, but the danger of that is that one day, rather than turn this other side, I'll knock you down into the earth. You know, so I can be mean.
Let's call him a driver, so that we. I can allow you. I have one final question.
Okay.
And this question, I want to explain why. I know that what you do. Some of us follow you. For the news, I can be sure that when I get a gist on Twitter, I want to show that who is talking about it. Because Twitter is where people that get free data. Free data will just come and abuse, just wake up and abuse people.
It can be disgusting.
So I want to know, okay, what am I saying this? That means, okay, let me go and research. Mm. 5 years ago, I used to be a banker. Yes.
Okay.
I wrote an article, Lagos, Place of Restlessness. That was the article. I spoke about Lagos, how people are rushing in Lagos. It was really funny. I put some comedies inside and I sent it to you. You posted it on your website. We never met. You don't know me.
There are a lot of people. I still went to some company to sign books, and one of the PR person was telling me about exactly your story. The difference is just his name and the title of his own stuff. And that's why I left the site there and didn't, shut it down.
Please don't. I'm using it to tell people. Even though I'm in people, I'm telling you about
that. But the thing is, I think, power, fame, money, all the privileges that accrue to us because of our work, they come with responsibilities. So when you get more power, when you get more money, when you get more fame, and even beauty sometimes, they come with responsibilities.
Beauty shadow.
Your privilege, there is no privilege that doesn't come with a responsibility. And one of the responsibilities is to try and create spaces for others to dream. So for me, it's a responsibility. It's a responsibility that comes with power, that comes with fame, that comes with privilege. And the more you do that, the more you get to even rise yourself. You don't even have to have a strategy. The more you give back, the more you try to help others, you lift others. Because people will come out for you. It doesn't even have to be those that you've helped. Humanity, the world, the earth will rise for you.
Are you going into politics? Do you have plans to? We need people.
There's a lot you can do intervening for Nigeria. I was in Kenya the other day. I stood for Nigerians that they collected bribes from. These Nigerians, till today, they don't said anything about that treatment. But I stood for them. I wasn't mad. I was not badly treated myself. I stood for them. When I go back to Nigeria, I wrote an official email. I'm going to follow it up to make sure that not only do those people get fired, that thing stops in that airport. So initially, we needed government to do things like that. But the world is changing. Individuals can intervene. Government will always have the most power to make change happen. But where we as individuals, as a collection of individuals, organizations, where we can make change happen, we'll do it. And that's what I intend to do for now. If something happens and I find myself in government, it's just an opportunity to do it in a much bigger way. But for now, I'm not thinking of that.
But you want to play your song now? Just one song. Let me give you something that I think you might like.
This was forever.
You know this one?
I love it.
You know this one?
I love it. All the first 4 or 5 albums of Slash.
Who are these albums?
Extraordinary. This was the first one.
Ace.
He shut down the entire country.
outside
even by
any language.
Any language. I can see people for what? Are you the one for the I want you to know that you be no one. For surely, young Shadro. You know what I mean?